Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Barbell, and welcome back to some more Fallout 4 action. I am super excited to record this episode because I finally took some time off camera to investigate things and start learning about the damn game. I decided that being ignorant of everything is not fun to watch. So I took some time to look at stuff. First off, I went through my inventory. If you can see here, I have no junk here anymore. And I will show you why. Over here at the workshop. No! Shut your face! Get out of here! Stop! What is this involuntary dialogue menu? Get away! I'm trying to show the people stuff! Oh my god, he's staring at me. He won't let me leave! He's like, you're mine now! Alright, here we go. Transfer. Hopefully you can see my cursor. I don't remember if it records my cursor or not, but right here I'm circling a T to store all junk. Clearly I don't have any junk in my inventory right now, but if I did, I just press that button once and all of it, bada bing bada boom, over in the workshop. That's how we do. And I also looked around in the workshop menu. Oh, really? I went third person? Why? Let's try that again. Why is it? It's... Okay, okay, things are going wonky. Things are going wonky. Okay, okay. I swear to Jeebus, I learned things. Alright, let's just bring it up that way. You're supposed to be able to bring it up with the hotkey V, but whatever. And I learned you could smelt things down, like right here. Look at this, you can scrap the mailbox if you want. Let's do that. And it tells you what you get. So if I scrap the mailbox, I get 6 steel. It's gone. I just beat that thing down with my fists, and now it is just a bunch of steel scraps in my back pocket. You can even take this log down. Why not? Let's do it. 12 wood. Let's do that. Let's get this street lamp out of here. Wow, that's a lot of goodies. Steel, rubber, fuse, and broken light bulb. You never know when a broken light bulb will come in handy. Now watch this. This is hilarious. You can just swiggity-swooty your way over here to this house. You can tear the whole damn thing down. 15 steel, 20 wood, 15 concrete, 5 rubber. Gone. No longer an eyesore. Can I tear this one down? Yep. Gone. Fuck these rubbish houses. We're building the new hotness. All these houses are old busted. I can take this car out too. Get out of here. And what I want to do before we leave Sanctuary is I want to build a little house for the dog. Now I need to remember where it's at. Is it decorations? Miscellaneous? Aha! There it is. So where should I put it? I think I might just like plop it down randomly, and then later on when I actually plan to build the actual settlement, I'll make it a little more fancy looking. We'll just put them right here. Do you mind? What a jerk. Okay, we'll put it here then. Build. Cha-ching! Can I also build like a little doggy dish? Nope. No food, no water, no nothing. You're just gonna have to scavenge for yourself, buddy. Cancel. Wall decorations, floor coverings. Can I give him like a little rug? There we go. Floor mats. I'll give him a little rug. We can go fancy. Here we go. Let's go fancy. Right there. Cha-ching! Alright. As of now, he has better living conditions than the other survivors here. That's a little embarrassing. So I'm proud of myself for figuring that stuff out. Look at that. That's awesome. I actually think I might have a dog dish. I remember picking one up. Maybe it isn't junk. I doubt it's an ammo. I don't think there's a doggy dish launcher cannon thing. I know I'm not the only person. So let's look in here. Canned dog food. For a second, I mixed up ceramic and dog food. I thought it said ceramic dog food. I'm like, well, that's kind of cruel. That fake dog food, though. Dog bowl. There it is. Okay, take. Someone. Inventory. Chunk. Drop. So now let's pick it up. And we'll put it right alongside here. Perfect! It has no food or water! Well, it should fill up with a little bit of water, but it's there. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna tell the dog to wait here. Wait, how do I talk to him? Stop. Stop. Talk.
How you doing, buddy?
Dismiss. Okay, so he should be dismissed now, right? Let me walk over here. Nope, he's still running. Oh god, he wants the booty. Oh no, he's just out there What's he doing? Oh god. Oh god, help! I'm being chased by a rabid animal! Help! Ah! Alright, maybe he wasn't dismissed. Okay, let's talk to him again. Hey. Hey. Okay, here we go. Talk.
How you doing, buddy?
How you doing? Dismiss. Dismiss!
Might be best if
thank you!
For a while, boy.
Sanctuary Hills, please. Yes, confirm travel. Dog is going to Sanctuary Hills. He should be here, right? This is Sanctuary Hills, right? Sanctuary. Okay. Please tell me Sanctuary and Sanctuary Hills are the same exact thing. It better be. Go to your doghouse, man. What the fuck? I built him this fancy doghouse with rug, mind you, with rug. That increases property value of his doghouse by roughly 150%. Roughly. And he's just out here taking a stroll in the rain. Well, whatever. I guess he'll come back here eventually. I hope I did that right. Another thing I discovered is, look at this. Have you seen this? Have you read about this? The Pip-Boy can be turned into super power mode for a flashlight. I was complaining in, I think, the previous episode. I was like, is there a flashlight in this game? Well, sure enough, there is. That's pretty cool. If any of you actually wonder how to do that, just, if you're on PC, hold down tab. And I guess if you're on console or something, just hold down the button that brings up the Pip-Boy. And boom, instant flashlight. Pretty sweet. I also repaired the right leg on this armor, so now it's all symmetrical and junk. I don't know if you can actually hang the armor on the power rack, like it is in the main menu where it's like actually hanging on here. I'm not sure about that. I didn't spend too much time trying to figure that out, but if you can, please let me know. Because I don't like it just sitting there. Like, I want it just hanging on there to look fancy. You guys cold? You need food? You need beds? Too bad. I need to venture. Okay, so let's open up the skills. I don't know if I mentioned that I took a look at this or not, but I did. Off camera, and I realized that just because these things are highlighted does not mean they're the only things I can invest in right now. As you can see, we'll just look at this skill, for example, Vans. Let Vault-Tec guide you. The path of your closest quest target is displayed in VATS. And at the bottom of that little box, it says required int 1. So it requires 1 intelligence, which I have, what, 6? And something else I found out is you can scroll down! I didn't even realize that! So there's 10 levels. And what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns. Each column is aligned to, you know, each stat. So this column right here, all these skills are for, perception. And there's levels too. See, 10 levels? The level corresponds to how many stat points you need for the skill. So level 10, these are all 10 stat points required for the skill. So if we go up here to 6, actually to 7, because I actually have 7 in charisma, I can unlock this right now if I want to. So I don't have to go, you know, in order from level 1 down to 7. I can just unlock it wherever I want. I believe. I haven't actually tried to choose it yet, but I think that's true. So that's pretty neat. And I also discovered, if you guys recall in the last episode, I said, maybe I should be a sniper. That sounds pretty cool. Well, ironically enough, the skills I invested in are the exact opposite of what you want as a sniper. I think you want perception. I think you want agility and you want luck. And I didn't invest in any of that. Okay, I have 2 points in agility. Big whoop. Want to fight about it? So that's kind of embarrassing. I think I might actually spend some of these on stat increases. Let's see here. Affects the recharge rate of critical hits. I did look into VATS and I'm way more comfortable using it now. I now understand that action points are both your stamina and that bar in VATS. And each use of VATS requires a certain amount of AP based, I think, on the weapon. So I don't know if it's the weapon weight or just the type of weapon. But the minigun used way more AP for a single use in VATS than, say, the pistol. The pistol, I think I could get off 3 shots if I have full AP. So I'm understanding that now as well. But I don't exactly know critical hits yet. I don't know how that works. I will figure that out. It affects the number of action points in VATS and your ability to sneak. So I think, actually, we should go into Perception 1. Yes, confirm. Pew! Because I think this really affects sniper things. I think there's actually a skill here just straight up called sniper. Where is it? Awareness. Rifleman. Oh, I know there's a sniper skill. Don't tell me there isn't. I remember seeing it. I will find you. And I will unlock you. There it is. Sniper. It's all about focus. You have improved control and can hold your breath longer when aiming with scopes. And that's a perception skill. Requires 8 stat points. I have a whopping 2. Hooray. Let's see. What else? I do like charisma, though. I do like my investment into charisma. We're actually going to do... Where's the follower one? Yeah. Who needs friends anyway? When adventuring without a companion, you take 15% less damage and carry weight increases by 50. That's pretty handy. I really like the dog, but I also like traveling on my own a lot, so we're going to invest in that. Now, as you can see, for level 2, now it says requires level 17 and charisma 3. So as you invest, requirements become higher. That's pretty cool. We might actually get some luck. Let's get some luck. You feeling lucky, punk? And... not sure what exactly else I want. This might be cool, but I don't know of any shops yet. Maybe one of the survivors here is a trader, but I don't know. That might be handy. Ooh, I do want some of these crafting skills, though. I think I'm going to hold on to this next point. Just kidding, I don't think I am, because I'm going to level up soon. So let's go ahead and get another one in agility. Another one in agility. Am I out of points already? Did I goof it up? Oh yeah, I got 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I had 3 points. Okay, my bad. We're good for now. Is there anything else I wanted to talk about before I go? I don't think so, but hopefully you guys could see maybe a little bit of a change in how I'm operating in this game now. Oh, I think there is one important thing I need to change. Settings, controls. Yeah, attack. Let's change attack to mouse 1. By default, it is mouse 1. But I changed it to get some screenshots for the thumbnails. I really go ham when I get the thumbnails for my videos now. And I really go through a lot to set up certain scenes to get a good shot. So sometimes that requires me to remap certain buttons. No big deal. Just switch it on back and it's fine. Okay, I guess we can cook some food too. There's a couple things I still don't understand. Well, not a couple things. There's like 5 billion. But here's an example. See, Nuka Cherry, HP here. There's this little clock symbol. I don't know if that means if it increases your health by 50 for a certain period of time or if it just like restores 50 health. I'm just not sure. So maybe I should cook some food and then when I take damage, I should eat some and see what it's all about. Deathclaw steak. I feel like the Deathclaw things are way more valuable than to... Oh, it tells me right here. Big blowfly, increased radiation resistance. Plus 15 max health for 1 hour. Ugh, blood bug steak. I won't eat none of that. That sounds nasty. Get infected with parasites and junk. Crispy squirrel bits. Small health regen for 2 hours. That seems pretty... Deathclaw egg omelet? Grilled rad roach. Here we go. Now, how come that doesn't tell me what it does? Grilled rad stag? Radical! Iguana on a stick. Muralurk cake? Mirelurk? Muralurk? I'm not sure which. Mole rat chunks. Plus 5 AP for 15 minutes. Remove 50 points of radiation. Wow, that seems like a really good one. Just straight up remove 50 points of radiation. Rad scorpion ribeye. Wow, an actual food item. What's that do? It doesn't even tell me. So I'm wondering, for the ones that don't tell you what they do, I wonder if they just give you some health back. Maybe that's the default thing, and then some of these are just special. So I had what? The cockroaches. Cook. And one more. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching! It's like everything gives me money and experience. Although I think the cha-ching is just giving me experience. Okay. Let's see if the rad roach tells me. HP 30. So maybe it just gives me 30 health when I lose health. Kind of like a stimpak. Speaking of stimpaks, how many do I have? 3. Wow. Yum yum deviled eggs, okay. Didn't expect to see those in there. So, oh, I also changed the gear that I'm wearing. I'm wearing the Minuteman outfit as well as Raider boots on left and right. Let me check. Apparel. Whoops! Whoops-a-daisy! There we go. Raider left leg and Raider right leg. So I'm also guessing that the little shield right here is physical resist. The lightning bolt is energy resist. Am I right about that? And the Minuteman outfit gives plus one agility, plus one perception, which is actually what I'm trying to invest in now. So I guess down here tells you the total amount of protection you have, which is 4 physical, 4 energy. What's this? Are these caps right here? Is that my caps? My coin! And my carry weight. Okay. So do you guys notice a little difference in how I'm performing in the game so far? I hope you do. And I just wanted to thank you guys for sticking with me during these first 2 episodes, because I will absolutely admit that was very painful to watch. I was so clueless, and it looked like I wasn't willing to learn anything, but I'm definitely trying. I want you guys to see that. And now that I actually know a little bit more, I'm more comfortable in the game, and I'm actually enjoying it more. Because I'll be perfectly honest here, because of how I was doing in the first 2 episodes, I was very concerned with my ability to enjoy the game. And if you really want me to be honest with you, I was briefly considering canceling the Let's Play so I could play a character on my own. Play through the game. That way I'd know what to do and then record a Let's Play where I'm a little more, you know, competent in the game. But I spoke with one of my friends and he convinced me not to do that. And I should just, you know, do some things off camera. And I think that was a good idea. So I'm just gonna, you know, have this flashlight on. I think the flashlight influences your detectability, but we've already been through here once, so that's not a real big deal. It's fine. And I'm sorry about that that lengthy intro of me just blabbing, but I just wanted to display the fact that I'm taking the time to learn the game. And just in case any of you don't own the game yourselves and you want to see how it works, I don't think I've actually been in here. Hard hat. Tin can. Oh, look at all this stuff. This is like a straight up hardware store? What is this? It is hardware! Okay! The hardware store. Can I not take these? Oh. Used oil can. Oh, I thought that was a sledgehammer. I was like, hell yeah, let's beat some ass. But no, it's just a broom. I guess now we can sweep some ass. Ugh! These look slightly used. God, could you imagine? Oh my god, that terrified me. I thought that was a naked body. I was like, oh, break out the sensor bar. Could you imagine if you could actually return a plunger somewhere? Be like, yeah, the clog was a little too intense for this, but you could have it back if you want. It's still like soaking wet and all nasty look. Oh god. What are you two doing? Oh my. Got anything else in here? Man, I love this flashlight. Pretty cool. What's this? Okay, I think I've determined, like, the official motto of this Let's Play. In Skyrim, it's, I do no damage. In Fallout 4, it's, what's this? We got it. We got it now. Okay, I don't see anything else to loot. Oh, just kidding. Light bulb and screwdriver. What's this? Mr. Handy? Can we get another one? That'd be pretty cool. Light bulb. Ooh, those look good. Fuse. Fusion? Ha! Man, if we could fuse with the dog, that'd be radical. Super Saiyan Dog Man. Just chucking Kamehameha blasts all over. Okay, there's a real reason why I'm in Concord right now, and that's because somebody said there was a bobblehead I missed up in that room where we met, oh, what's his name? What's his name? Preston, I think? Anyway, let's go ahead and dance our way in here. Alright. Now, there's a couple things in VATS I'm still unsure about. One, as I mentioned earlier, the crits. I don't know exactly how the crits work. Also, I know when you open up the vats, there are these percentages, and I think that's the percentage chance that you'll hit the target. But also, above the percentage number is a little health bar, and I think that's the health bar of the specific limb you're targeting. And what I'm wondering is, once the health bar reaches zero, does that mean that body part is crippled? And if so, is there any benefit in continuing to hit that body part? Or once the body part is crippled, should you start aiming at other things? That's kind of what I'm wondering. So, like, take for example the chest. I shoot the chest 4 times, and the health bar of the chest is at 0. Would it be more beneficial to start aiming at the arms or the legs instead of hitting the chest again? Or does it not really matter? Hopefully you understood that question. I'd appreciate any response. I know there's some Fallout experts out there. I am the complete opposite. I am the Fallout newbie. To the extreme. The Grand Nubius Maximus, if you will. The Supreme Nubius Maximus. The third. What's this? See, there I go again. What's this? I can't resist saying that. What's this? What's this? There's skulls in the fridge. What's this? I don't know why that's in there. What else was there? Oh, tin can. Activate? Oh, okay. That just shuts the door. So I'm getting the vibe that straight up looting everything is actually beneficial because you can take all the junk and put them to use in the colonies. Now in Skyrim, a large majority of the junk was absolutely useless. Absolutely useless! Like, cups, forks, knives, unless you wanted to take the junk and strategically place those items yourself inside of your home. But even then, what happened to the heads of these people? They're just gone! Well, there's this head here. Can I, like, take it? Oh, God! How do you rotate? Can you rotate? Ooh! What if you could punch this while you're holding it like this? Oh. No! Head! Head's McGee! He's gone! Open the door. Let's just break out old trusty. Just to be safe. Ooh, there's a terminal here. Robco Fun? Read.
Nice. Nice.
You've collected an issue of Robco Fun, includes the Atomic Command holotape game. Neat. That hat is obnoxious. So zoom in, enter take. Okay, cool. Coffee pot? Give me that. I'm not gonna look at that right now. There was a oh God, I'm knocking shit over! I'll take it. Probably one of my favorite things about this game so far is the looting system, where you don't have to, like, open the file cabinet. You just look at it, you know what's inside, take it if you want, leave it if you don't. Oh, there it is! So, perception bobblehead, take.
Perfect.
Only through observation will you perceive weakness. Your perception has been permanently increased by 1. Oh, hell to the yeah! That's one of the skills I wanted to start building. Thank you to the viewer that commented that. I'm sorry I forgot to write your name down and I feel terrible about it. But I appreciate you letting me know where it was. Any good stuff in here? Ooh! Microscope. Yes, I know the terminal's back there. I'm just looking around. I didn't really loot everything here last time I was inside. And I don't know if I mentioned this, but now I understand that AP is both stamina and your VATS bar. I was extremely confused by that when I was running around in the power armor just yucking it up and I was sprinting around everywhere. I was like, where's my stamina bar? Meanwhile, I didn't notice that the little gauge in the bottom right that said AP was going down every time I sprinted. Oh God, that episode was a mess. So thank you for tolerating that. Okay, now I need to see if I can remember how to do this. Cheap house. I think somebody said when you take a guess on one of these, it'll tell you the likeness. Like if you're wrong, but it'll tell you maybe some of the letters were correct. Let me try this. Likeness equals 1. Okay, I'm not entirely sure what it means by just 1, but it's similar to trust, I guess. Which if I had to guess, I'd say maybe tasks or texts. So let's try tasks. Likeness equals 0. So if it's like trust, but not like tasks, I don't heads. Oh my god, that's ironic considering we just carried around a decapitated human head about 2 minutes ago. Maybe texts. People also said once I reach my final attempt, I should just back out of the terminal and then go back in. And I think you get all four attempts back. Yeah, okay. Text. Ooh, but it changes up the password. Okay. Okay. I'm cool with that. So there's tasks again. Daisy? Likeness is zero. Somebody said when I was complaining that it didn't tell me how to hack properly, it actually did come up with a prompt and I missed it. I feel terrible for that. Scene. Let's try scene.
Sweet.
Oh, okay. Well, just got it. Unlock security gate. What security gate is that? Maybe it's the one that was locked with an advanced lock downstairs. Maybe so. Okay. Can I go back? Oh, shit. I wanted to look at the logs. They're dropping logs in the terminal. Oh, that's nasty. Roaches in the basement? After hours tomfoolery. For the last time, the red coat mannequin displays are not toy soldiers and are not to be played with after hours. Ugh. Two of them have scuffed paint, and this morning one of the foot regiment pieces was missing his arm. There was apparently scuffed paint on the booty of several mannequins. Oh god! What were they doing? This sort of horsing around will not be tolerated. Anyone caught engaging in such behavior will be written up, docked an hour's pay, and charged for damages. Chief Curator, Harold Nash. There's one more I want to look at. Final entry. Ooh, maybe I don't want to do that. Oh, hang on. I broke the lock on the curator's desk and took the gun. I'm going to hide in one of the rooms for a few days until things calm down. If somebody reads this, please come find me. But if you try to... How do you go to the next page? Oh, here we go. Hurt me. Ah, oh, I goofed it. I done goofed it. I got too hyped about the next page. Hurt me. If you try to hurt me, I swear I'll shoot you. Interesting. Does it say what room she's in? I broke the lock on the curator's desk and took the gun. Okay, so let's see if we can find her body, maybe find a gun? That'd be cool. I don't think this is the curator's area. Maybe it is, but I don't know. That just says exit. Let's look around. Let's investigate. What's this? Give me your stuff. Maybe over there. Wasn't there an upstairs area that I failed to look at last time? I think there was. Also, let me know if the light bothers you. For now, I'd like to keep it on because it helps me, and I think it might help you guys as well. Okay, I think I looted all these. There was an area where I did a shimmy along. Here we go, right here. And there was upstairs. Let's check upstairs. Or did I go through? Yeah, I just went through here and got the Nuka-Cola. God damn it, I was feeling smart for a second. Then it always gets shot down in flames, and now I'm like, oh, that's right, I'm stupid. I forgot. Okay, we got anything in here? No. You should be able to take one of those mannequins and put them at the house. Whoa, that stuff. Beer bottle, I'll take that. Surgical scalpel? Okay. Tablespoon? Hell yeah! Now we've got eating utensils, we don't have to eat with our hands like a bunch of cavemen. Bag of cement? Oh, that's probably handy. Oh, so it wasn't this gate that opened. Toolcase, ammo box.
Don't think I can pick this.
Okay, so there's a security gate somewhere? Unless it was referring to this security gate. What's this? Oh my god. I can't resist saying what's this? I'm so sorry, that's gotta get old. Oh god, here we go again. Storm, rays, sling, shiny. Let's go with shiny. Fuck. Likeness, one. So when it says likeness, maybe it's like it's a word similar to shiny? Okay, storm then? Likeness, two. So shiny and storm. Scene? Ass! Well, let's back out. Try again. Why does it feel like I'm zoomed in way more this time? Am I crazy or did I like really press my face up against the screen? Food, sands. Noted. Bonus. Bonus! Likeness 3. I really wish I would have seen that prompt that tells you about hacking. Bonus ideas? No. Damn it. I'll give it one more try. There we go. Okay, so I did press my face up that time. Codes. No. Virus? No. Also, is there any benefit to selecting one of these symbols? I don't know. Round? Damn. Alright, well, I'm gonna wait until you guys comment and give me a little more pro tips about hacking. But I did notice the likeness thing, so I am listening. Wait, I came through here at the start. I need to, like, procedurally investigate this place. We need to find the curators. Maybe it's, like, not even a thing. I'm reading too much into it. I don't know. I think it might be a cool find if I can, well, find it. I feel like the curator's office has to be the one Preston was in. Watch that first step, baby. Oh, can I take any of this? Take the chairs? No. Okay. What are we, about 30 minutes into the episode and not a single bullet has been fired? Which means 99.7% of the audience at the start of the video is now gone. So hello to all three of you still watching. I appreciate it! Okay, so maybe this was the curator's office. I don't want to take too much longer here. I really don't. Okay. Either I looked too much into it or I just couldn't find the curator's office, but let's go ahead and leave. Okay, so now we're back up to the roof where the power armor was and the minigun right here. What's this? Ooh, I'll take that. What's this? Damn it, I'm doing it again. I have to condition myself to stop saying it! Duct tape, cool. Is there, like, a safer way down? Apparently not. Let's just hop up over here. Ooh! 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 Oh, the night sky! I can't believe I haven't looked at it yet until now. Oh, yeah. That is awesome. I love nighttime. I love astronomy. I love all that space goodness, so just looking up like this just makes me happy. Oh god, that looks like a leg-breaking distance. Oh, don't make me go all the way back through the museum. Like, can I land on those little pedestals underneath the windows? Is that risk worth it? Let's try it. Quick saving. Oh my goodness! My leg! Oh, well now's my chance to try out the food. Aid. Oh, damn it. Oh, damn it! I'm goofing it! I was doing so good! Here we go. Grilled rad roach. Okay, sweet. Oh, does it give me radiation though? Let me look. I don't think so. Let's eat another one. I have a little rads right there, but I think that's from previous things. Concord Speakeasy. Okay, this makes me wonder. Maybe the curator's office wasn't exactly in the museum, but it was somewhere else. Beer bottle, ashtray, cigar box. And this dude died with beer bottle and cigar! Maximum, I don't give a fuck that the nuclear apocalypse is coming! I'm gonna enjoy my treats. If I'm gonna die, I'm going out happy. I can respect that. Scissors, dirty ashtray, cigarette, cigar. Ooh, another Yushchenka hat. Packs of cigarettes. Let's keep old Trusty out here. A little concerned somebody might be creeping along. God! What is this? What kind of horror nightmare is this, Chunk? It's got a plunger! They're gonna plunger you to death! Never mind the two guys with machetes, he has a plunger. Run! Take the skull out of the toilet. Get out of here. Oh my god. It's a nightmare. Go away! You're spooking me! Give me the machete. Oh no, don't drink that! Oh god. I just drank nasty skeleton corpse dirty bathwater. I feel unclean. Man, let's just take the machete out of the booty. It takes the machete out of the booty, or else it gets the hose again. Oh, come on! I told you there were scuff marks on the booties of the mannequins! I told you! Oh, let's turn this back on. Comfy pillow. Hell yeah, that's going on my bed. The other survivors in the town, they can have the pillows that have been in use for a long time and they're no longer comfy. Just like all deflated and junk. What's this? Anything back here? No. Listen, it's even playing tubas and junk like Outlast because of these mannequins. I want to get out of here. I can't lock or pick that, right? Hello? Can I just pick up the mattress, put it in my pocket? Nah. Blamco brand mac and cheese. Okay. What's this? Vault Tech lunchbox? Give me that. So I don't know if I've talked about it yet, but in the last episode I asked for suggestions for the name of the dog. And I haven't told you what I've chosen yet because I haven't chosen. You guys left so many great suggestions. I really have to commend you on that. So many funny choices to pick from. So it's taken me a little time to decide. I hope you don't mind. But I think it'd be a cool thing to name the dog something else other than Dog Meat. Although some of you informed me that his name is Dog Meat because that same dog or a similar dog was in Fallout 3 by the same name. So I guess they're trying to keep that going. So I understand, but for a little more personalized touch, we're going to name him something different. And I see Nuka-Cola! Ass! There's no cola in here! I feel ripped off. What's this? Nothing. Oh, I said it again. I should add like a what's this counter to the videos. It's over 9,000! What? 9,000? There's no way that can be right. Has to be way more than that. Okay, so I think we need some action in the episode now. I swear to Jeebus. We listened to this in the last episode, and I swear to Jeebus, Baby Sean was pooping all over the holotape. I heard it. Can't tell me that wasn't what I heard. Also, is there a slide we can go down? There has to be a fun slide somewhere. Here we go! Get hyped! Whee! That was fun. What if when I went down the slide, it just gave me an agility level up or something? That'd be awesome. Also, who the hell has a sofa on their back porch? No offense to anyone who actually has a sofa on their back porch. That wasn't exactly an insult. I'm just surprised at that extra sofa on the back porch income they apparently have. What a weird place for a stoplight! Oh my god. Oh my god! Do we have combat? Vets! Fire! Goof him up! Oh, can we do one more? Torso, I said. Aw, oh, shit. Body part? Okay, so now let me switch. Okay, he's dead. Cool. Ugh. it's got two heads! Double the cow, double the meats. Although, it doesn't seem we can loot it for meats, so that sucks. Why can't we have some meats? What about him? He's fresh. Although he's not exactly fresh looking. See, I told you guys I learned a little bit about vats. I did it. I'm doing it. I'm learning. So, we need some more action now. Let's go ahead and look at the map. Red Rocket Truck Stop. Is that a whole new, area to build? I guess we're close, so we can look. We are close, right? Oh, we are literally right on top of it. Let me see if I hold down the workshop button. Okay, so yeah, we got a whole new settlement right here. Now what I'm curious about is, can you tell your settlers which area to go to? Now let's just scrap some tires, why not? Let's scrap some more tires. Oh my god, I just got 60 rubber out of that? Chemistry station, that's cool. Did that say milk? Milk! I need milk! Although I have a feeling this milk vending machine is now a cottage cheese vending machine, if you catch my drift. Okay. Now if I also recall, all of these things, they're like a giant chest, right? Now I feel like I'm supposed to have way more junk than that. Shouldn't I? Let me exit for a minute. Let me go to, I think there's a workshop in here, right? Yeah. Let's look. Transfer. Junk. I thought I had way more junk. Alright, store all junk. Yeah. There we go. Did I accidentally take all the junk out when I was in the workshop last time? Maybe I did. Huh. Either way. Because I thought all the workshops were like interconnected and they were all just one giant global chest. Like if I stored two things here, they should show up in the workshop over back at Sanctuary. So I'm surprised that all of the junk that was in there wasn't actually in there when I opened that up. Room, take. Right away. Oh, that's cool. Cap stash, that's even cooler. What have we got in here? I'm not really interested right now. Let's just go somewhere else. I'm not exactly jumping at the bit to read employee logs. Cigarette carton, phone. Okay, let's just store these things too while I'm here. Cool. I'm not going to fool around with weapons crafting or armor crafting right now. I'm probably going to do that off camera. Also, something else I'm considering. For any of you who watch my Skyrim series, I have a secondary series that goes along with the main Let's Play called the Hearthfire series, and it's all about house building and minute things like that that don't really belong in an actual, you know, main Let's Play. And I'm thinking maybe I could do something similar for Fallout because, oh man, what's it called? Settlement building seems way more in-depth than the Hearthfire in Skyrim, so I feel like that could be cool to watch, but maybe not exactly in this main series. So let me know what you think about it. I'd have to say it's highly likely that I'm gonna do it. Stubnose pistol. Oh, we got a new pistol. Pork and beans. Casual outfit. How casual? We must find out. What the piss? That ain't no man's outfit! I'm casually cross-dressing! Also, what the hell? Oh god. Wait, let me put my good stuff on! Okay. Now run. Okay. That sounded terrifying. Oh my god, they're everywhere. Fire! Yeah! Okay, these dudes are way better at following you over terrain than they are in Skyrim. Get goofed on. There's another one, I think there is. Oh, there's two more. Get up there. Where are you at? Where are you? Okay, go! Get that goofball! Get that silly goose! Get dunked on! God, what a goober. Alright, reload! Run away! Okay, I have a question. Let's find out if I can use a melee weapon in VATS. I have something cool, right? Switchblade? Yeah, let's use a switchblade. Equip. Actually, do I have any food I can eat before I attempt this? Apples. Oh, here we go. That's good cockroach. Holy God! Okay. If I sit this, you gon' die. Oh, beat down! He's like, bruh. What is this? Drink? I ain't drinking that. Just kidding, I'm gonna drink it. Taking a risk. Yes, I got radiated on. It's everywhere. Okay, I like the switchblade. Ooh, you just kinda poke him a little bit, little pokage. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. What's this? Little slice and dice, okay. So I guess there's mole rat recipes we can make. All right, be honest guys, in the comments, do you notice a difference between this episode and the last one? In terms of competence in gameplay, let me know. I really hope the answer is yes, because if it's no, I'm like, oh God, I'm worse than I thought. I just heard somebody. I will throw down, sir or madam. Do not think I will not throw down, because I will. I have turned into robot. I'm gonna tear your fucking oh shit, they have guns. They have guns? Since when were there guns in this game? Okay. Let's see what kind of weapons I got. Oh, we got the laser musket. I forgot about that. Okay, equip and then retreat. That's the plan. Just a little bit. Reload. Oof. What the hell is this? Oh God, fire! Get the hell out of here. Okay, get closer, do it. Okay. Oh, wrong button. Okay, here we go. That's fine, do it. Oh, I saw the critical thing, I saw it. Get goobered. I'm a goofy goober, rock! Dun dun dun, dun dun dun. You're a goofy goober, rock! Oh, nailed it. Oh, she like, bruh. He too good. Use that stim pack, boy. You can't find me, I'm in the trees. I'm like a Keebler elf. Where is this fuck? I'm gonna get that booty. Gradual swiggity swooty action. I'm coming for you. Oh, shoot me all you want. Ain't gonna make no difference. I have you now. Just give me a second. Yes. Oh, this is so much fun. Use a stim pack. Why not? Oh, this is great! Who knew that games were more fun when you knew what you were doing? Okay. We quick saving and we stealing some stuff. Ooh, stim pack, I needed that. Whoops. Oh, well actually that's fine. Let's look, So one thing I'm really liking right now is it looks like cooking food is worth a damn in this game. And I apologize that I keep comparing it to Skyrim, but that's just what I'm gonna keep doing. And in Skyrim, it was essentially useless. There were only a few soups and stews that were useful in Skyrim. Mainly vegetable soup for melee characters and elsewhere fondue for mages, I think. Other than that, meh. Ooh, trash. Oh, I love trash! I don't know why, but walking out onto this made me think of Resident Evil 4. With the big water monster in there. Like, I think if you shoot the water enough, the monster just straight up comes out and gobbles you up. He is sick of your shit. Also, what is that? Looks like a... Oh, it's one of those cow things. They're not, you know, hostile, are they? Oh, look at that! He's all concerned! I'm not gonna do nothing, bro. I got that kind's peace. Alright, so let's use fast travel for the first time. Yes. Okay, and we're back here. Is he using his doggy house? No. Shit, man. So where does the dog go when he doesn't use his doggy house? I hope I can find him. You know what I should do? Make these guys perform manual labor on this house just non-stop, and then just one day come in here and just scrap the whole house and be like, whoops! Everything you did was for nothing. Sorry about that. Ooh. Harvest. Did they plant melons? Who the hell did some agriculture without my permission? Excuse me. Where's Farmer Joe Brown in here?
We should keep moving. Don't want to be pinned down when the raiders come.
Go fuck yourself! I don't want your two caps. Shut your damn mouth if you know it's good for you. Ah! I got spooked by the pumpkin. What am I doing? Oh yeah, that's right. We need to cook some more. I'm gonna talk to her eventually and maybe see if we can patch things up a bit. Okay, let's try this. Okay. I know there's a cooking pot somewhere else, like down the road there, but I want to make one right here because apparently this is where you fast travel. Let's see. Crafting. Armor, work, chemistry, cooking station. Okay. Does it need something I don't have? Oh, requires rank local leader. I don't know what the hell that is or how to get it. Oh well. Okay, let's just go down here then. So while I do this, I just wanted to kind of pimp out my Twitter a bit. And not because I just want more followers, but I wanted to encourage you guys to follow Twitter because I use it for posting updates on videos and communicating with the viewers. It's a great place to ask me questions if you have any questions. I respond to as many as I can, so feel free to follow the Twitter, or follow my Twitter. There's a link to it in the description of every video. Just a suggestion, you don't have to obviously, but just an idea. I think we have more rad roach, right? Yeah, here we go. Cook. What else can we make? Mole rat chunks? Don't mind if I do. Oh, that's not a healing item. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there's stats on the left. Guys, I can look all over the screen and not just in one specific area. I can look everywhere. I didn't know that. I can use my eyes. All right, well, let's make this. Yeah, let's make all these. Why not? Mongrel dog meat. What's that do? Straight up health. All right. Yeah. Okay. So we don't just have to rely on stim packs. Deathclaw stick. That HP! I'm gonna save these Deathclaw ingredients. I feel like I said earlier, they're way more useful. Requires dirty water and razor grain. How do you just get water? Huh, I don't know. I guess we'll make some of this stuff. I think cooking it should remove the rads from the water. I sure hope so. So let's make another one. Okay. Exit. Really, you sit on a cinder block? There we go. A little more comfortable. Okay. What exactly else does the Stimpak do, just to clarify? Okay, so Stimpak is a percentage heal. So I guess the higher your health bar gets eventually in the game, a Stimpak will heal more compared to static healing items like the roach stuff, I guess. Like the mutton chops will always be 40 health, even when you have 500 health pool. but a stim pack will be 30% of whatever your health pool is. I think I'm right on that. That's pretty cool. You know what? Let's just eat one while I'm thinking about it. Mutton chops, sure. I sure burn everything to a crisp, don't I? I guess you don't want to risk not cooking thoroughly enough and getting radiation poisoning and stuff. Oh, wait. I see a doghouse over here. Really? Really? You use this pre-built one? I built you one with a fancy rug and you hang out over here. Come on, brew. Oh, well. At least I know where he's at now. Okay, so let's go ahead and accomplish something for today. Because so far we've done nothing. I want to go to Ten Pines Bluff. So we'll do that and then we'll end the episode, I suppose. Wait, let me make sure that's what's marked on my map. Yep, that's what it is. I don't think I've leveled up yet this episode. Oh, what's this? Oh, damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. I went to the water in the last episode and it's like, it hurt me when I went too deep. Yeah, okay, well, let's avoid that. We've got some more stuff over here. Ugh. Damn, lady was fishing when the bombs dropped. Well, that sucks. Oh, I can take the fishing rod? Cool. Can I actually fish with it? Can we catch, like, Simpsons nuclear contaminated fish? Is it a junk? Oh. Oh, I can't actually use it. Oh, man. It looks like a swing. Like, there's a rope and it looks like a little piece of- Oh, no! I got submerged in the radiation! Got all up in my face. So, my legs are still super sore from leg day. It was about 2 days ago, as of recording this video. And I feel like an old person. Ooh, were those both legs? Like, every time I go to sit down, I have to go like, ugh, ugh. It's crazy, I can't just sit down. It's like, oh, my legs are so sore. It takes so much effort just to get up. Let's see, leather, left leg, leather, right leg. Let's check those out as opposed to the Raider ones. Yeah, I think those are cool. Although they might be identical to the Raider legs. Let's look at the Raider leg. Oh no, the Raider ones are a little more janky. A little more rusted to let you know that they're bad guys. Okay, so let's just do regular ones. I know I have a left arm, but I don't want it. Look, it puts a freaking... Oh, wait, that's the wrong one. Okay, well, I'm gonna keep that. I think it was the Raider left arm. Yeah, is this it? Hey, look, it puts a basketball hoop on your arm. I don't want that. I don't want people shooting hoops while I'm trying to rob them. Let's put the regular leather left arm on. Hopefully I can find a right arm. Oh god, I'm one of those guys with the single shoulder pad. I hate those... Like those armor sets where you just get one giant shoulder pad. I'm sick of it. Symmetry, we need things to be alike. More remains. Drink. Oh, that guy's submerged. Okay, let's get to the freaking objective. I've blabbered and accomplished nothing for like an hour. So of the three people who stayed to watch this episode earlier, I'm guessing two out of the three left already. So there's one person watching now. Thanks! Okay, I think we're getting close here. Also, there's a bunch of cars. Does that mean junkyard? That looks like a bunch of cars on the mini-map, or on the compass. What the hell is that? What the fuck is that? Is it sentient? Is it gonna blow me up at a moment's notice? What is it? I'm the stealthiest character. Okay, I guess it's not on. That is scary looking. Oh god. Oh man. Oh god, oh man, oh no, the trap! The trap, I fell into it! It's Admiral Ackbar's car! Oh no! Bad news bears. Come on, man! Well, this is a little embarrassing. Oh hell yeah, he's using the doghouse now! I'm back in Sanctuary because I had to reload a save after I got stuck in Admiral Ackbar's car. And it took me all the way back to right before I fast traveled here the last time. So that sucks. I just wanted to come back in real quick to say, hey, he's using the doghouse now with Fancy Rug. See, that's the important part. You have to remind people that there's a Fancy Rug there. Or else, why would the dog want to stay there? What's his incentive to stay in another doghouse? It's the Fancy Rug that gets him every time. Anyway, I'm going to go cook the food that I cooked last time, and then I will be right back when I reach that junkyard that we were at when I got stuck. Okay, as we're approaching this junkyard yet again, I just wanted to say thank you guys very much for your continued support on these Fallout 4 videos. A new series is always very difficult for me to get started, so I just wanted you to know that your viewership and all the comments you're leaving is definitely appreciated by me. They do not go unnoticed. So, let's try and avoid getting stuck in another vehicle. Saying vehicle like that reminds me. Somebody heard me call Melee in the first episode and they thought I was serious in that pronunciation. No, I just like pronouncing words in a weird fashion on purpose because I'm dumb. Like, example would be debris. I call debris or debris. The Melee. You know, I'm just a goofball. What's this? Fat man, what the fuck? Oh, it's a little... Oh, God, what? It's like a slingshot with a bomb? Bombs? Rope? Lamp oil? All these can be yours if you have enough rupees. Okay, fat man. Go away, fat man. Let's equip it and look at it. Oh, my God. The jankiest RPG I've ever seen in my life. But I guess it works. Okay, let's put that away. Far away. Also, in the time when I was, you know, when I had to come back up here off camera, I also bound a few more weapons to keys. So we got that snub-nosed pistol I found earlier. I also have the switchblade here. And of course we have old trusty. But I really like this laser musket thing. Pretty neat. And it's the most sniper rifle-esque thing I have at the moment. Also, I'm just beginning to realize that this is not, in fact, the place I wanted to travel to. Wow, it's only halfway to Ten Pines Bluff. Okay, so let's stop sneaking. Let's look around for good stuff. Oh, that door. That door's a little questionable. This. I'm a little scared. Should I go through? Quick save, for the love of God. What is this place? Who are you people? Military grade circuit board. Ooh, that has to be worth something. Duct tape adjustable wrench. Terminal, we'll use that in a second. Hot rodder.
Perfect.
Ooh. Permanently unlock a new custom paint job for your power armor. There's paint jobs? Hell yeah! Take. That's cool. Another military grade circuit board. We got another stim pack. By the way, I know this episode is pretty long, but in the spirit of keeping things awesome, we're still going to travel to Ten Pines Bluff. Is that what it's called? Ten Pines Bluff, yeah, in this episode, so don't worry. Terminal, use. Let's see what we got. Delivery log. Sentry bots. Robo brains. iBots. Protectrons. Defective Mr. Handys. Protectrons. Okay. Employee notes. Oh man. Holotape. Let's look at the holotape. Playtape. Ugh! I do not want to activate that! Please! Let's just take the holotape, I guess. Exit. I'm guessing that's the sentry bot down there. And if I activate that, it will blow me to smithereens. And then consume the remains. Not because a robot, you know, requires sustenance, but it would just add greater insult to injury. It would be cool if I could, like, take it home somehow. I don't know. Maybe activating it does allow me to talk to it or something, but I don't want to take the risk right now. If that's the case, you guys are welcome to leave a comment about it, but until then, I'm not even gonna deal. I figured there'd be more goodies in here. Maybe not. Hope I can find more fusion cores for the power armor. Also, somebody left an awesome pro tip saying that if you fast travel on the power armor, it saves on the fusion core juice. I don't know why I didn't think of that before, so thank you for letting me know. Alright, I don't see anything else. Let's go on over to Ten Pines Bluff. Yep, I think we're good. The hell is that? Oh, it's just a bird. I'm a little on edge since everything is mutated and it's out to kill you. Everything on this planet has evolved to kill humans? Wait a minute. Fallout 4 is after Earth! Dun dun dun! Oh, the horror! That movie. Any of you know what movie I'm talking about? Directed by Shyamalama Ding Dong himself. M. Night Shyamalan. Is this extra power armor? Huh. So it's got a torso, helmet, right arm, and right leg. I don't know why I shouldn't take those. Or should I take the power armor as a whole? I don't know. Like, maybe I should. Because I think taking the torso, helmet, right arm, and right leg is just taking, like, the covering on the power armor skeleton. Like, see, there's no left leg, but there's still, you know, a skeleton of a leg there and a skeleton of a left arm. I'm gonna leave that there for now. Maybe I should put a map marker down. Right? Shit. Man, it makes you get so close. Ah! Ass! I'm goofing it! Zoom in. How do you place a marker? Wow, right clicking makes you zoom in even more, like with your face. Oh man, I wanted to put a marker. I don't exactly know how to put one. Local? Oh, okay, there we go. That works, I guess. I don't know why it made me go into the local instead of the world map to set one. Oh, now it works! Why? Whatever. We got it done, and we're quick saving. So this looks like a crashed helicopter Osprey thing. Ooh, what you got? Nothing. He's like, I died with nothing in my pockets just to make you mad. He planned that out all beforehand. What a jerk. Okay, I'm gonna leave that there. That's right. We decided that. Oh, ammo box. Uh-oh. What? What? I'm ready to throw down. The enemy marker went away. Was it the cow? I'm so ugly, the cow briefly turned into an enemy. Either it's a cow or like a deer or something. Can't remember the name of it. What's it called? Rad stag doe. Okay. So it's a radiated stag. What the hell's that? Uh-oh, we got the mole rats. Bring it on! I got a switchblade. Let's go. I know you're here. Oh, see, now I'm prepared so they don't want none. Ah! Ah! Oh, pop, pop, pop! People are playing paintball, I wanna join! Wait, oh, they're bad people, run away! Wait a minute! Oh no, attack dog! You gonna get it now, boy! Huh! Huh! Oh shit. Wait a minute, I need to eat some meats! grilled rad roach? Yeah, eat that. What else did I make? It needs to be able to separate between food ingredients and cooked food. That'd be nice. Med X, resist damage, that's pretty cool. Mole rat chunks? Yeah, yeah, that's another thing I made, didn't it? Or isn't it? Okay. Okay, run away a bit. I know I'm using up my AP, I remember that now. Okay, jump up. Jump up. Okay. Ooh, that was a little laggy there. Did they just shoot their own dog? What is going- Oh no, the stag! He sacrificed himself for me! So I'm gonna take your meats! Alright. Oh, you gonna get it, boy. Right in that head. Nailed it. Yeah! Red bandana? Really? Why did my pistol, like, slightly reload and then just re-equip itself? That was a little wonky. Okay. What the fuck? Someone just exploded for no reason! Oh, you're mine now. Let's just get a little mixed bag going. Nice shot. Yeah, see, the first shot was to throw him off. See, it makes him look away like, huh? And then the second one is the kill shot. Because I was holding my rifle sideways, see? Kill shot, that's a kill shot. Man, this battle music. I need to try out the crit. I want to try that out. Ooh, wild carrot flower. Oh, he's way down there. Bob and Weave, baby. He's kind of, like, frozen, too. What's he doing? Nice combat stance, nerd. I'm gonna get that booty. Alright, here we go. Where's the crit? How do you do the crit again? Space? I don't remember. I don't see the button. I'm looking. I don't see the button. I thought it was space. Oh, right click undoes the choice you made too. Like, see, when I right click it undoes it. Let's do that. Oh, there it is. Okay, it's space when you're in the shooting mode. Okay, I got it now. Although my first shot just obliterated him, so maybe next time. Also, something I forgot to tell you guys. Settings, gameplay. I'm on hard difficulty now, not very hard. So it's still above the average difficulty, but not on, for lack of a better term, legendary. And I think that's fair. It's still difficult, but not insanely difficult because I'm completely new to this universe. So I don't think I'm pussing out too much. Okay, there might be mole rats around. Oh, yep, there's one right there. Let me loot this here. Can I drink this? I'll take a little rads if it restores my health. That's fine. I don't care. Oh no! Oh no! Fucking rock, dude! Execute that crit, boy! I wasn't ready! Sweet, I leveled up. Oh shit! Get him! Huh! In the booty! That booty slice. Oh, it looks like whenever you level up, it restores your health too. Excellent. I like the switchblade. Pretty neat. And I guess all my points in strength don't hurt after all, since I'm using a melee weapon. Armor workbench? Cool. Dirty water. Okay, so you can just pick up dirty water containers. USAF satellite station Olivia? Oh. We'll go there in a minute. Let me look around. Do I have any junk I can store? Now, why does it do that? Why does it do that? See, I went here to store all junk. There was nothing in this workbench. And then I pressed store all junk. And then everything appeared. Like, when you first go to a workbench, is it not connected to your network of workbenches until you store all junk? And then it's connected? Is that how it works? I'm not 100%. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to go into the storing mode. There we go. Store all junk. Maybe that's how it is. Maybe you have to store all junk again to connected to your workbench networks or something. Or network. I don't know. So it seems a little goofy, a little finicky, but we're getting it. Well, that's a bad idea, sticking a screwdriver into a toaster? We are at the place, right? Nope. Oh my god. This is way farther than I thought it was. Well, I did tell you guys we're going to the bluff, so I'm gonna keep my word. We're still gonna go to the bluff after this. Also, have I quick saved recently? Now I have. Vodka. Canned dog food. What the hell? Wait a minute. It just said fusion cell 20. Is fusion cell the ammo for the rifle? I think it is. Fusion core, that's what I'm looking for the power armor. I apparently found one. I did not know that. But now I do. Ooh, baseball glove. Ah! She tried to kill me, did you see that? Did you see? It almost happened. Stab that barrel. Now he's dead. It's kind of cool. Look at that view. That view! Whoa, there's a lot of... Whoa, I thought I almost walked off the edge. There's a lot of buildings that way. Should put the knife away before I start running and then trip and fall on it. Any of you know that reference? Ooh, another dead rad stag. Rad stag. So if you want a little weightlifting pro tip, because I don't have anything to talk about right now. At the gym today when I was doing calves, there was something in my foot, like I tweaked something in my foot and it kind of hurt a little bit. And I tried to do a few more reps on the calf press, and it was like, okay, this is clearly hurting a little bit. I'm going to stop. And the pro tip is, whenever you tweak something a little bit, like tweak a muscle when you're at the gym, and you're like, ah, that doesn't quite feel right. At least try a few more reps and see if it still bothers you. Like, sometimes it's just a one-time thing where there's a little tweak and it just instantly goes away. It's like, okay, that was weird. But if it's still bothering you when you do a few more reps, my suggestion is just to stop. Either switch to another body part if you do multiple body parts in a day. Or also, what the fuck is that? Do you see that cruising around? What was that? Is that a tank or something? I don't want to die, man. I already died once with a death claw. Anyway, either switch a body part or just go home. What the fuck is that, dude? I guess we're going to find out. Oh, no. You want to throw down? I got my switchblade, boy. Okay, here we go. Light him up. Alpha. Oh, shit. My switchblade does nothing. Oh no! I got a little too confident. Okay, let's hide up here. Okay, wild. Let's look at the alpha one. How much damage does he take? He takes massive damage! Guys, you know what? Against an alpha wild mongrel, I do no damage. I do no damage. Alright. Do I have a quit? Oh god. A crit built up? I don't know. Let's at least get this guy. Oh, okay, so I guess with the melee weapon, you can do a bunch of things. And bats. Okay, he dead. Now, where's the alpha? Oh, I leveled up, by the way. Did you know that? Where is he? Where'd he go? Is he over here? Oh, God, oh, man. Oh, God, oh, man. Oh, God, oh, man. Okay, let's whip this out. He seems confused, though. Load. And let's get some vats a try. Huh! Slowly but surely. Gotta love the cheap tactics of hanging out on rocks. It's the best strat in every Bethesda game. You cannot tell me it's not. Okay, get him again. See, look, see the health bar? See, health's pretty much low. I don't know if there's a benefit to keep hitting that, but we're gonna do it. Cha-ching! Whoa! Whoa! That hype corpse! Oh, we're dog meat. That was pretty cool. Well, let's go ahead and eat. We hungry? Man, I wish I could find it. Mole rat meat. That's not cooked, I don't think. I wish it was a little more clear on what's cooked and what's not. Is the dog meat cooked? I don't think so. Mud chops is, I know that. Okay. Also, quick save. Okay, these guys look friendly. Man, they sure stacked the junk on top of that poor cow! Look at that! No mercy! Come on, guys! You can carry a little bit. Jesus!
Got the best armor in these parts.
Do you? What's for sale?
What kind of stuff do you have?
I sell armor for Old Man Stockton's outfit, based out of Bunker Hill. Been selling armor to smart wastelanders for years. The dumb ones walk away empty-handed.
Could you sound any more disinterested than you do right now? I don't think so. Barter.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Got plenty of stock. Take your pick.
Boiled leather. Champion left arm's got a star. That means it's badass. I have 205 caps. Dirty gray suit. I don't need that. I have a clean tan suit. Dirty postman. Dirty striped. Leather left leg. I think I have leather left and right legs. Lightweight leather. Lightweight raider. Right on. Okay, let's just sort by apparel right now. Shipment of ballistic fiber. Okay, so that's just junk. Cool. Ammo, 38 rounds. I could use those for my snub-nose pistol, right? I think so. I think it practically has a snub nose on the cover of the ammo box. Yeah, alright, let's buy some. Actually, just kidding. Let me wait. Because I have a perk I want to get. That might help with that. Whoa, my god! He's like, bruh! Sorry, dude. Okay, let's level up. This one. I'm gonna get that. Confirm. Pew! I really wish it gave a number. Like, how much better? Okay, so I think the value of the ammo was...
My armor saved many a wastelander.
This guy just doesn't give a single fuck.
Let's see what you have.
What you see is what you get.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, so it's still two pieces of dosh per round. I guess when the value is that low... Man, that's a lot of caps. I only have 200. Let's hold off. Let's just look at apparel. Newsboy cap? Patrolman sunglasses? Ooh, those might be cool. Let's buy those. Cancel trade. Wait, did that, like, cancel what I just did? Oh, man. Did I have to confirm?
Lucas.
Best way to spend your caps is protecting your
Yeah,
eyes.
Shut your ass. Let's just
sure.
barter.
Let's take a look.
My prices are firm.
Yeah, I get it. Patrolman. Okay. Buy. Oh, so you buy and then you accept. And then you confirm. Oh my god, enough steps? Come on, dude! He's like trying to sneakily look and see what I'm buying. How much coin you got? He's like, I've got 10,000 suitcases on my back. I can store plenty of coin. Right, let's put these on. Yeah, I don't know. They were cool at first, but then they look a little goofy. The goof meter might be a little too high. I don't know. I wish the sunglasses were just a little smaller. Oh well, quick save. Don't matter now. No going back.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
Okay, so let's talk to you. Caravan guard? Are you just a random dude?
The only way you get old in this job is assume everyone's out to kill you.
Okay. Well, pretty much everyone is out to kill you. Can I take these? Maybe. Let's try. Alright. This is what I'm talking about. They do the hard work of growing the crops and I just swiggity swooty on in and take them. I'll leave a little bit. I actually feel bad about taking those. Okay, settler?
Hi. Easy living, this ain't.
Well, back to the grindstone. What the hell?
Any more trouble around here.
Take it easy. I'm with the Minutemen. I'm here to help.
You see the
You're
glasses?
With the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing
traders.
I didn't
think you'd bother with lipstick in these times, but you did.
Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days after Quincy. Bad business, that.
What's a Quincy?
Is there something you need my help with?
Whew. Yeah. I'm damn glad you're here. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks.
Is her hand
food and
like floating through the
threatening
tomato?
Threatening to kill us all if we don't pony up. We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against a gang like that.
Will you be willing to join the Minutemen once I've dealt with those raiders?
Well, we'll certainly give it a good long think. People have gotten used to not being able to count on you folks. That's not going to change overnight.
Okay, I didn't expect him to say that dialogue. Hey.
Excuse me.
The farm's not much, but it's something.
Yeah, okay, I wanted to keep talking about the mission.
The crop's coming in pretty good.
She's like, I completely forgot about the raiders, now I'm focused on tomatoes. It's all I care about now. The tomatoes, really? What do you guys do, double up on these mattresses? Getting comfy, are we? Okay, so I think we're getting to the final portion of the episode. We're gonna do this mission and see what happens. There we go, sorry about that. Had to cut the recording again, but we are good to go. How much health stuff do I have? Maybe I should cook a little more. Roast. Grilled radstag. Whoa, that HP! That's awesome! More rat chunks. Mutt chops. Yeah. That's good. Wow! Yeah, let's cook that too. That's like our big health item. If we get in deep trouble, we're just gonna consume some ribeye. Make everyone jealous, just like sit down, plop a table down, have some steak, pour A1 steak sauce all over it, and just have a fancy meal. Water pump. Pump! Why am I doing this? Can I like put a container down? Do I have a container? Catch it in the baseball glove and then drink out of it. Okay, I don't know. Maybe you can put a bucket down. Mission? Where's it want me to go? As in data? The first step. Kill the raiders in Converga assembly plant. Show on map. Holy Hannah, this might have to wait until next episode. It took me forever just to get from here to here. And now it's going to make me go almost an equal distance to finish this out. So you know what, I think I'm going to save that for the next video. This was quite a lengthy one and I really hope you guys enjoyed it. But as I said, I'm going to go ahead and end it here. Thank you guys very, very much for watching. I think we're finally getting on track in this Let's Play. And I will see you all in the next one for some more Fallout 4 action with ridiculously oversized sunglasses. Take care, everybody. Bye.